Welcome back to Slips and Tips, everyone. My name is Chris, back for another YouTube video. And in this video, I'm going to be looking at the NRL final games for this weekend. We've got four games, which is all super exciting, spread out over the Friday, Saturday, and the Sunday for this weekend. So yeah, there's a lot to go through in this video. Now, before we get into the tips, guys, I just want to remind everybody, please support my socials, my YouTube channel. You know, please subscribe if you haven't already. My Instagram, we've got all my US Open and my FIBA basketball tips posted on there, as always. And my Telegram group. Now, my Telegram group is going to be very busy and very active during the NBA season. I love putting my extra legs in there, legs that I was considering, but you know, they don't really make the cut. So Telegram is always busy. It's always got some more tips in there. So be sure to subscribe. It's a free group at the end of the day. So that's that, guys. Now let's look at last weekend very quickly before we get into the tips for the NRL finals. Last weekend, we hit 8 out of 17 tips. So right under 50%, which is not good. I want to be over 50%. Like I say every week, you know, we've been pretty good for the past 3 weeks. So for this weekend, you know, we've got some fun ones in there, but for my value flips and whatnot, I want to make sure that we stay over 50% because that's the long-term goal for this channel. So before we get into the tips, guys, for the NRL finals, let me just remind everybody, please gamble responsibly. This is not financial advice and no one, including myself, has a 100% guarantee way for you to make money. This is all a prediction. This is all about having fun. So if you feel like you're losing control or if you feel like you're losing too many units, please know there's a lot of help and support out there that can help you. This is all about having fun at the end of the day, so please gamble responsibly, guys. Now, with that out of the way, let's talk about game one. So game one, we got the Broncos versus the Storm. This is going to be a big game. I'm so excited for this. It's at Suncorp. There's a lot to talk about, so I'm going to do my usual format where I'm going to go through first things first, you know, talking points, then I'm going to put up the stats on the screen, and then we're going to end off with the tips for this game. Now, for this round as well, because it's finals and because I was thinking I'm really going to miss the NRL when the NBA starts and when we're 3 months ahead from now, I'm going to look back and think, oh, you know, I wish I had some higher, riskier, funner ones. So for this round, guys, I've decided to do my usual flips, my usual best bets, but I've got a fun one at the end for each game where I think, you know, if one of these hit, you know, they're all 30X, 20X and whatnot. So we're going to have a bit of fun this video, but I'm still going to stick to my usual format. And yeah, there's a lot to talk about for this game. So this one's super exciting. So let's get into it, guys. We've got this one's at Suncorp. This one's going to be 20 degrees. Now, it's actually scattered thunderstorms projected weather-wise. So the weather's actually not looking good. It's probably going to be a wet field. It's going to be windy. I mean, from what I've seen so far, it's Wednesday afternoon. It's not actually looking good weather-wise. So let's just keep it in the back of our minds. Now, I've got so many talking points, guys, so let's get through it before we get into the tips. Like I always say, it's always good to kind of mentally prepare and think what's going to happen for this game, regardless of the odds, regardless of even looking at, you know, any markets or anything. These are the first things first that came to my mind anyway. So the first one for me is how the regular season is different to finals footy. Now, finals footy is a whole different ball game, just like the NBA. You know, they say the playoffs, just make it to the playoffs and you've got a chance, because when you get to that level and that pressure of the finals and, you know, the playoffs and whatever it is, you've got so much more, like, less errors you can make. You've got so much more pressure. You've got sold out arenas. You've got basically elimination games. So everyone is playing to their absolute maximum. I think most of these NRL players at the back of their mind are thinking also, if I get injured, the season's coming up to an end anyway. So they're running just that little bit extra harder. They're completing more sets. We see a lot more games go under because there's so much more defense being played. And these are the best of the best teams at the end of the day who made the finals. So that's the most important thing for all these finals videos that I make. I just want to remind everybody, finals footy is different from regular season footy. And once you make it to the finals, just like the playoffs, it's almost like a whole different season has started and any team can say to themselves, we have a chance. Now, looking at Brisbane, guys, for this game, the Broncos have lost 14 games in a row and the Storm have won 24 of the last 26 meetings between these two sides. That is a very alarming stat. Now, I know I just said finals is different and everything's different, and that is true. However, you can't ignore the Storm stats. Last week, it was the B-grade teams versus each other with all the players out, but we still saw the Storm win. So their confidence is going to be through the roof. The Broncos have not beat the Storm at Suncorp since 2009. So looking at a home advantage, yes, it is a home advantage, obviously. But looking at that stat, it does make you wonder how much of an advantage is it? My next talking point is Pappenhausen, how good he looked last week. He played the full 80 minutes, but Meany has been named at fullback. So Craig Bellamy had to make the big decision to put Meany or Pappenhausen at fullback. And obviously he's gone with Meany. I actually think it's the right decision. I think Pappenhausen can come off the bench, play dummy half and just make an impact that way. Whereas Meany deserves this spot, you know, all season. He's been their guy. He's been great. He's consistent. He's a great player. So that's another interesting talking point. The next one is Adam Reynolds instilling confidence into this young finals Broncos side who they're lacking finals experience. He's the key to the Broncos winning. If Adam Reynolds has a good game, which he usually does, he never misses. If his kicks are 10 out of 10, if his playmaking is 10 out of 10, he's in the most important position, in my opinion, for this Broncos side. He's got the most experience, like I said, looking at both teams as well. I think the Storm have pretty much tripled the amount of finals games experience compared to this Broncos team, who are very young. So you have to consider that as well. The weather being bad, like I said, so the unders might be a good option here, maybe if you like that. And 50,000 people are expected to be attending this game. So the pressure is going to be through the roof for these, especially these young Broncos players. My last talking point is the Broncos losing five of their last six final games, and they're playing their first final game since 2018. So all things to consider, like I said, we're looking at the finals game being different to the regular season and how important it is of the lack of experience versus the Storm. Now, with that being said, guys, let's look at the stats, guys. Stats on screen, as always. Pause the video, have a read if you want. I've chucked in a lot of stats here because there's so many interesting stats for this game, more than the others. So, yeah, have a pause, have a read. I mean, there's so many exciting try scorers you can pick from. These are my favorite try scorers. But, yeah, I mean, I can't lie. The stats favor the Storm heavily. So, with the stats being done, guys, let's look at the tips, guys. My first flip, as always, I'm looking at what I can give you guys the best bet, in my opinion, what I think is the, I guess, safest in a sense of what is the highest likely scenario. And it's going to be Cobbo anytime, just straight anytime. Now, he scored 20 tries in 24 games at Suncorp, which is an insane stat. It's going to be his game to shine. It's going to be a big game. I think he loves the big games. And I think the Broncos, because it's a finals game, they won't really get many cheap and free points or cheap line breaks through the middle. They're going to have to play to their edges. If Cobbo gets his opportunities, even if he gets two or three, he can convert one of them. He's so consistent. He's great at finishing. I've got to back him anytime at Suncorp, regardless of whatever, whoever I think wins. Now, I've paired him up with over 26.5 points. In my opinion, like I always do every single week, if you know me, if you know my style of betting, I love my clean 2x, 3x, 4x odds. I just like to keep it clean. So for this one, you know, the 26.5 points adds to that. It makes it nice and clean for me. That's why I've taken it. I think, you know, either one of these sides can, they can probably both drop 20. However, if the weather really is a massive factor, then this might actually not be so much of a safe leg. But I don't think that's going to happen. I think both sides are stacked with attack. So that's why I like the over 26. Very realistic. Now, that's my first flip, guys. Now, for my next flip, I'm looking at, I paired up Munster and Reece Walsh, player A or player B, anytime to score. Stats back both of these guys. They're both amazing. I love both of them personally. I think Munster loves these big games. And this is actually a home ground for him in origin time, you know, as a Queenslander. So Suncorp is his home ground. I think that's why the Storm have had so much success as well. So yeah, him and Reece Walsh, they're both electric. If Reece Walsh does get a line break, he's going to be scoring. I have no issues with him as well. I paired that up with Storm plus 19.5. Now look, for me to pick a winner this game, it would be obviously the Storm. If I had to pick, I would say the Storm. But I can't do that outright head-to-head. The Broncos, they have so much to play for. They have so much to prove. They know all these stats, guys. They know more than anyone else how bad the Storm's record is over them. But I still think the Storm can get it done. Now, am I going to do that for my best bet for you guys? No, I'm not. But I'm going to give them 19.5 points for the Storm. That's over three converted tries. Me seeing them winning and me seeing them keeping it close. And if they do lose, I think it's probably going to be 1-12 for the Broncos. So this is a huge line. Yeah, I feel so confident in them. The stats back them. And I can, you know, go on and on about how I think the Storm can win here. But I'd rather avoid it. I'd rather fade an outright winner, give them a line for this bet. So those are my two flips, guys. Like I said, as always, these are my favorite bets, my best bets. I'm chucking four units on each of them. And if you combine all four of these legs, you get $4 odds, which I'll be chucking two units on as well, in the hopes that we just get a sweep. Now, like I said at the start of this video, I'm doing some fun bets. So for this one, for this game, I'm looking at a fun bet. I'm looking at one that's $11.50 odds. This is Katoa anytime for the Storm. I think, you know, Elise Katoa, he's scored one try in four of his last five games. So he's red hot. He's looking for the line. His form is great. And I think if the Storm, you know, as one of the Storm's best forwards, I think he's going to come on this game and think, all right, I'm the main guy. I'm going to be the guy to step up and, you know, hopefully get a line break and just come on the field and just provide so much explosion for them. So I've got a good feeling about him. It's a fun one, like I said, but I paired him up with Storm 1-12. This goes back to what I've been saying this whole rant. I think the Storm can get it done. I think they've got all the stats to back them. If I had to pick a winner, it would be the Storm. However, for the sake of the fun bet, I've gone with the 1-12 margin because it's going to be close either way. and I just can't look past them. I know the Broncos at home. I know they're stacked. I know Adam Reynolds, like I said, can win them this game, and he can. But for the sake of the fun bet, I'm chucking one unit on it. So, yeah, that's my fun bet, guys. Now, if you want to combine absolutely everything that I've talked about in this segment, it's actually 39.50 odds, which is pretty insane. You've got Katoa, Storm 1-12, Munster, Reece Walsh, you know, all those legs I've been talking about. So that's also a pretty fun one. I'm going to chuck a cheeky unit on as well. So look, that's how I see this game going, guys. Like I said, it's going to be amazing to watch. I can't wait. We watched them go at it last week at the B grades. Now this is the Division 1 team, basically. So yeah, I'm super keen. Game 2, we got the Panthers versus the Warriors. This is going to be another exciting game. This one's our blue bet. It's going to be 17 degrees. It's going to be sunny and dry. So weather-wise, much better. Perfect playing style for both of these teams. These teams struggle in the rain, and I think this weather, these conditions, sunny and dry, is perfect for them. That's my first talking point, guys. Now, for my second talking point, I'm looking at the Panthers' amazing record against the Warriors, winning their last 7 games against them. So confidence-wise, they're going to come into this game thinking, we're going to win. We beat them 7 times in a row. However, I have to note as well, for all these Warriors stats, you have to take it with a grain of salt because this is a different Warriors team. Over the last 2 or 3 years, they've struggled with relocating, COVID, all the sacrifices they've made for the league. So you have to kind of take it with a grain of salt. But Panthers are the Panthers. We know how good they are. You know, they're going to have the home ground advantage as well. My second talking point is Ivan and Nathan Cleary's relationship towards the Warriors. You know, Ivan being an ex-coach, and Nathan Cleary coming out publicly and saying how much he loves the Warriors growing up. Shaun Johnson was his idol and all this stuff. So you've got an added layer of psychological kind of want, I guess, or need in this game for Ivan Cleary and Nathan in this game. I always look at these components as if I was a player and I'm versing a team or my idol that I grew up with, I'm just going to want to go to a different gear. I'm going to want to play my best footy. It's not going to intimidate me. It's going to make me be more motivated than anything. So I always talk about this psychological stuff here and there. It's not everything, and it's probably not a huge deal, but it's something worth talking about. Now, Luai is still out for the Penrith Panthers, which sucks, but I think Jack Hogg is actually doing okay. It's been a bit of a nice combination with him and Cleary. He's done well to fill the gap, so I'm a big fan of Jack Hogg, but obviously Luai is Luai. We'd rather him in there. Now, for the Warriors as well, a big plus for them. They've rested for this game, so they're coming in rested last week. Against the Finns, they couldn't get the job done, which kind of probably shows a bit of their depth issues. However, at the end of the day, it wasn't a game-breaking game. They didn't need the win. But all the Warriors players, the main guys, are rested. So that's a huge plus for this Warriors team. Now let's look at the stats, guys. Stats on screen. Check it out. Mainly favoring the Penrith Panthers, of course, with their amazing record over the Warriors and them being at home and whatnot. We're seeing a lot of 13-plus results for Penrith over the past few weeks as well leading up to the finals, so that's pretty important. So yeah, check out the stats, guys. Pause the video if you want to have a read, and yeah, these are my favorite stats that I've gathered. Now the fun part, let's get into the tips, guys. What am I looking at? Like I said, same model as the Broncos and Storm game, 2 flips and a fun one, and then a final combination of everything. So let's talk about the 2 flips, guys. My main bets, my main tips that I'm putting out there, that I'm putting 4 units on. I'm looking at Panthers race to 10 points. I see them winning at home, and I see them showing a defensive masterclass this game. I'm not a hater of the Warriors. I mean, me and everyone else loves the Warriors, and if my Raiders lose, I'm probably going to jump on the Warriors bandwagon. However, I can't ignore Panthers' defense. They are the number one defensive team for a reason. When they're at home, they're even better. They don't let their opposition score more than 3 converted tries throughout a whole entire game. They just know how to shut teams down. Yeah, I think they're going to get to 10 points first. Mainly not because of their attack, but because of their defense. I don't think the Warriors can score 2 tries straight off the rip unless they just absolutely ambush Panthers in the first 5 minutes and stun them. But Panthers should be in control. I think they're going to score the first try. I think they're going to score the second try. So race to 10 makes sense. I paired that up with under 46.5 points. Like I said, I see a defensive masterclass coming from Penrith. It's so hard to ignore the defensive stats. I know the Warriors are a team that are capable of going, you know, 20 points, 30 points a game once they get going, but Penrith aren't a side to just let that happen. They can make in-game adjustments quickly, and the stats back the unders as well. I think this could be an under game, mainly due to Penrith's defense. So the third leg of this flip is the Panthers minus 2.5 line. As you would have probably could have guessed, you know, I'm backing them to win this game. Minus 2.5 is basically head-to-head. I mean, basically a try, not even a converted try, but I think they're going to win. I think they're going to win at home. It could be 30+. I don't want to say it because I love the Waz. I love the bandwagon. I love all the compliments and the love that they're getting. They deserve it. But I do have to say Panthers, I think, will just be too good for them this game. That's my first flip, guys. Like I said, three legs, you know, pretty straightforward, favoring Panthers. I'm not looking at try scorers, mainly the under and, you know, Panthers dominating the first 10 points, sure. Now, for my second flip, nice and easy, I'm looking at Critter anytime. Him and Munster are my two favorite players, obviously, besides all the Raiders boys. But outside of the Raiders boys, you know, Critter and Munster are my two favorite players. So I have to include him for an anytime. He's paying $2. Anytime he's paying $2 plus, I'll take him because he's just an absolute try-scoring machine. And he loves the big games. He loves the big moments. He's shown how clutch he is. And he's someone who does not, you know, shy away from opportunities. They call him the intercept king now because he's always actively trying to make some action. He's trying to get some, you know, some things going for this Panthers side. And the stats back him, he scored a try in four of his last five games. So yeah, I love Critter straight up anytime. Nice and easy. Flip my units. I love it. If you combine all that, guys, it's $4 odds. Again, once again, I'm going to probably chuck 2.5 units on this in hopes that we get a sweep. And that's the end goal for this game. Now, like I said, fun one. Let's get to the fun one, guys. This one's $6.50, so not crazy odds. But if you know me, this is kind of out of my usual range. But I'm looking at the Warriors over 5.5 first half points. It's one converted try. Whenever I see this in an NRL game, I'll probably take it more often than not because we basically just need the Warriors to score and convert the kick. I'm going to take it. It's pretty self-explanatory. I think the Warriors can score in the first half. They might not get two or three. However, I do trust SJ's kicking or whoever's kicking. It's Pompey. Maybe it's Pompey. I think they're going to be decent and going to get the conversion. So one converted try, I'll take that. I'm going to pair that up with DWZ and To'o to combine for 2+ tries. So I think one of these guys, To'o himself, can probably get this. However, I have to put DWZ in there somewhere. And yeah, I just couldn't fade him. He's back. I love him. He's one of my favorite players. So yeah, I'm a big fan of him and To'o, obviously. So yeah, combining for 2 tries, once again, self-explanatory. And then the third leg of this $675 multi is Panthers 13+. Once again, sorry, Warriors fans, don't hate on me, but I just see Penrith, once again, putting on a defensive masterclass and just winning this game by 13+ points. If they keep the Warriors to 2 or 3 tries, I think they're capable of scoring 4 or 5 tries. So we'll see how we go, but I think the Panthers are just going to be too good. They've got all the finals experience. They're hungry. They want it. So yeah, that's my big fun one. Now, if you combine all of those, including the fun one, it's 38.25 odds. So pretty juicy. Yeah, I'm going to be chucking a unit on that for some fun. Now, let's jump to the third game, guys. The Sharks versus the Roosters. This one's at PointsBet Stadium. It's going to be 14 degrees. It's going to be cloudy and dry. Let's talk about talking points. Sharks on and off form this season. You know, they're a team that go through 3 losses in a row, then everyone says, oh, they're done. Then they have 3 wins in a row, and it's like, oh, this is a top 4 team. And then they go back to losing. They're very streaky, and this season has been a season where they aren't showing their defensiveness as they did last season, which kind of sucks, and I think that's why they've lost a lot of these games. And I will say this, though, Sharks at home are a better team. So it's at PointsBet. It's in Cronulla. There's been a lot of criticism and talk around, you know, how much money the NRL is going to lose. I think it's reported they lose $1 million in revenue just because it's at PointsBet instead of a Sydney arena. But they got the home ground advantage. The Roosters have won 7 of the last 8 meetings against the Sharks. So a very alarming stat if you're a Sharks fan. And the Roosters' late surge of form at the end of the season. They've won 5 in a row. And I did say at the start of the season, I actually picked the Roosters to win it all. They have so much depth in their team. Every single player is pretty much a rep player or could be a rep player. And we're seeing this late surge of form now where I'm saying, okay, hang on a second. This is a team that I picked to be in the finals and win it all. Now they're, you know, in the top 8. That's all they need, a chance. It's finals footy. So, yeah, just have to talk about that. Super interesting. The last talking point is Craig Fitzgibbon up against his old mentor, Trent Robinson, from the Roosters. So this is also another, like, Ivan Cleary moment where, you know, with Webster, where, you know, this is from his old staff. So you have to talk about that as well. Now, stats on screen, guys. Check it out. Favoring the Roosters here. Pause the video and have a read if you want to read my stats. And, yeah, these are my favorite stats for this game. Now, the tips. My first flip. Once again, 2 flips and a fun one. Looking at the first 2 flips, guys. My first one, I'm paired up Ronaldo and Suali'i anytime. Now, both of these guys are strike weapons. Suali'i didn't go over for us last week. We needed him, and he didn't. He had a quiet game. I think this is going to be a big game, bounce-back game for him. And Ronaldo at home is always so good. He's been an absolute beast. He scored a try in 10 of his last 11 appearances at PointsBet. So, yeah, I think both of these guys could go over. Pairing them up makes me like it even more. And then pairing that up with Roosters 5.5 points, basically for them to get a converted try to start the game. Honestly, I see them winning. If I have to tip a team, I'm tipping the Roosters to win. You see it in my fun bet, but I think the Roosters can get the win here. Now, throughout the week, the odds have been changing. Right now, as it stands, the Roosters are just favorites, but there's good value in them head-to-head. But at the end of the day, I just see them getting the win here. I think this late surge of form, they're the hotter team coming into this game. I don't trust the Sharks and their streakiness. And I think if Tedesco, Soili, Sam Walker, all these big guys have a big game, which they probably will, you know, that's enough for them to win this. So yeah, I'm going to back them. But for the sake of this flip, I'm giving them 5.5 points, which is basically a converted try. Now for my second flip, just like the Penrith game, I'm taking one try score. I'm taking Tedesco here. Now, as a fullback, he's Mr. Clutch. He loves these big games. He's had a pretty horrible season, actually. So I think now he's finding his form. He's finding his confidence. I think he's going to carry this Roosters team. He scored last week. He looks so fit. And he's scored in 6 of the Roosters' last 8 finals matches. So, yeah, when it comes to finals time, he's Mr. Clutch. He steps up. So I'm taking him just to score. Now, if you combine all those legs together, guys, once again, you get $4 odds. So I'll be doing that as well for a cheeky few units. Now, let's go on to the fun one, guys. This one's $11.25. Looking at a fun bet. I'm looking at Sam Walker anytime. Since he's been back, he's come back with a vengeance. He scored a try in his last 2 games since he's been back. And I think he's just proving to Trent Robertson and everyone, he is an NRL first grade player. He's so exciting. He doesn't have the biggest body, as in like a, if you compare him to other people in his position in the league. However, he's just quick and he's really good playmaker. So I'm a big fan of Sam Walker. I think he's going to score for a bit of fun value. And I paired him up with Roosters 1-12. Going back to my main points I was just talking about, I think the Roosters can get the dub. So that's why I like it 1-12. It's going to be a close game either way. So that's $11.25. Now, if you combine that as well as all my safer flips, you get $34.75. Once again, pretty fun. Going to chuck a unit on it, see what happens. Now, let's go into the last game of the round, guys. Let me wrap this up with the Knights versus the Raiders. This one's at McDonald Jones Stadium. It's going to be 16 degrees. It's going to be sunny, dry day. Another great day for footy. Now, this one hurts because the Raiders are my team. If you don't know me, if you're new here, I'm a Canberra boy. I love my Raiders. But I got a tip with my head here, not my heart, because you'll see why in a second. We'll get into it. There's a lot of interesting stats for the Knights, though. Now, first things first, Raiders are missing Papali'i, Horsburgh, and Sebastian Chris. So those are massive outs. All 3 of those dudes contribute a lot to this Raiders side. Over the last 10 matches, the Knights have won 6 and the Raiders have won 4. So it's not overly imbalanced in the sense where the Knights have pumped them the last 10 games. It's pretty even. The Knights right now, though, they're on a red hot streak, winning 9 games in a row. The Knights are very balanced. These are some points that I wrote down. And I just think they're a very good team. And what I mean by that is they've got so many strike weapons evenly balanced across the whole park. Anyone who's got the ball can produce something for them, and they're not heavily relying on Ponga anymore. I think at one point a few seasons ago they were, and that's why they weren't seeing so much success. Now they're just very balanced. When I think of them, I think of balance, just like the Warriors, very balanced. Now the Knights, these are some interesting stats, guys. They're going to be in the stats, but I'm going to talk about them now. The Knights have conceded 2 tries on average over the last 9 games. That is a very impressive stat. That is a defensive masterclass stats. Because over their wins, not only are they winning, but they're keeping the opposition down to 2 tries on average. They've also scored more tries than any other team in the competition this season. So that's more than Penrith. That's more than Broncos. That's more than any other club. They are the leading club for scoring more tries, which is an amazing stat. My last talking point is the Raiders earning their spot regardless of points difference. Obviously, I'm biased here, but my Raiders just got the wins. That's what you got to do. You just got to know how to win. Doesn't matter if it's ugly. It's been ugly. But they just know how to win matches, and they just know how to get over the line, and they just know how to close out games. So another talking point I had to bring up. Now, guys, stats on screen. Check it out. Favoring the Knights here because of their red-hot form. However, the Raiders do have some stats to back them as well. So, yeah, check out these stats, guys. Now, with those stats out of the way, let's talk about the flip. My first bet, my first flip, I'm looking at Dom Young. I had to include him. I couldn't avoid him. This is going to be a finals game. I think he's going to be clutch. I think he's going to step up. And yeah, he's basically at home as well. There's a big reason why I like him in McDonald Jones Stadium. I'm keen to see how he scores. His stats are amazing. He scored 1 try in 7 of Newcastle's last 8 matches when they're favorites. So he's been red hot. He's a leading try scorer, one of the leading try scorers for the whole regular season behind Isako. And he's just been an absolute beast. So I'm taking him anytime. I've paired that up with Jamal Fogarty, 2+ points. Now, I think Raiders should easily get 1 converted try throughout the whole game. The kicker is not going to change because Croker's not playing. So at the end of the day, Fogarty is the kicker and he will be the kicker. So I'm confident that he stays as the kicker and I think he gets 2 points. And I pair that up with Knights head-to-head. So head-to-head, Dom Young, Fogarty 2+ points. It's hard to avoid the Knights here. It hurts as much as it does as a Raiders fan, but I've got to pick the Knights at home. It's going to be a sold-out crowd. atmosphere is going to be amazing. They've got the momentum, they've got the history, and they're our bogey team for the Raiders at the end of the day. That's my flip, guys. Now, my second flip, keeping the same theme here, looking at one try scorer, looking at Kalen Ponga anytime. He just loves versing the Raiders. Before even looking at the odds, I was hoping it was $2 or more, but I got him at $2. And yeah, basically, he's their fullback, and he just loves scoring against the Raiders. I don't know what it is, but he scored 4 out of 5 games against us. So yeah, I've got to back him again. He's been electric, and now it's finals time. He's got to clutch up. So those are my two flips, guys. Now, my fun one for this one, it's $7 odds. It's a lot of try scorers because I think this is going to be a high-scoring game. But basically, we've got Hudson Young. He's also a guy who loves versing the Knights team, just like Ponga loves versing Canberra. He scored a try in 4 of the Raiders' last 5 games against Newcastle. He's an absolute beast. I think with them missing all these guys like Chris and Horsburgh and whatnot, he can step up as the big boy and just go over the line and just crash over. I can see it happening now. I pair that up with over 42.5 points. The total, this is the point line set by the bookies. I think it's going to be points galore. Like I said, I don't see much defense being played. I think it's going to be all about attack. However, the Knights, in saying what I said before, they're keeping the opposition down on tries and points. So that's something to be wary of. I pair that up as well with Wyden or Best anytime. So play A, player B, Jack Wyden, Bradman Best. Both of these guys are so electric. They're both beasts. This could be Wyden's last game as a Raider as well. So he's probably going to step up and have a massive game. And then my last, the fourth leg of this one is the Raiders plus 33.5 points. Absolute joke. It's the highest you can get. You can give them as a head start. I think, obviously, they're not going to win this one. However, 33.5 is a massive line. It brings it to $7 odds. That's why I did it, if I'm being completely honest. And yeah, I think the Raiders can at least compete within 33.5 points. So that's $7, guys. If you combine that and all my other flips, you get $24 odds, which is pretty hectic. So yeah, that's how I see this game going, guys. That one hurt, not going to lie. But yeah, it's going to be an interesting game regardless. So those are my tips for this round, guys. NRL Finals, I'm so excited. Be sure to subscribe to my Instagram because I've got all my US Open, all my FIBA basketball tips up. When the NBA season starts, like I said, I post daily tips, put a lot of time and effort into researching for you guys, getting you the best stats, and I'm always looking for the highest likely scenario to get them green ticks. So thanks again, guys. If you're still watching, please subscribe if you haven't already. Appreciate the support. Let's get them ticks, and good luck, everyone. Cheers.